Hello and welcome back to the Dream Saga. My name is Cody, and today, for Candy Tuesday, we're actually going on a little cookie trip. So, a coworker of mine had a daughter going through the Girl Scout cookie section, so I bought a bunch. I bought the two flavors that I absolutely love, Thin Mints and Samoas. With that, I also got these that I'd never seen before. They're Toffee-tastic gluten-free cookies. And so I'm a sucker for toffee cookies. And so there's a coffee shop in the place I work that actually sells very much like Starbucks. They have a toffee, like a toffee-type cookie. But it's fantastic. Warm it up, melts in your mouth. Fantastic. Anyway, that's not about that. It's about Girl Scout cookies. So let's get right into it, shall we? All right, so the first box that we're going to get into is Thin Mints. These are, for a lot of people, a staple. You know, when you think Girl Scout, immediately Thin Mints comes to mind. From what I've been told, and like the few documentaries I've seen and just articles and things like that, as long as it's not, you know, something that isn't true, from what I've been told, the Thin Mint cookies are actually made by two different companies. So some of the cookies are a little bit thinner, less chocolate, still that nice Thin Mint taste, and some of them are more chocolate, like they have more chocolate layered on top, which is kind of nice. So, four cookies, that's all you're allowed to have. Otherwise, yep, yeah, it's just a little bit of protein, hey. A little bit of protein. On the back, ooh, what a girl can do. The Gold Award, the Girl Scout cookie, or the Girl Scout Gold Award is the highest award a Girl Scout can earn. It is awarded to a Girl Scout seniors or ambassadors who complete a project that will make a lasting difference in the world. That's quite nice. Enlarged to show detail. Yum. So we got a nice little sash. This shows the Junior Gardener Badge. Girl Scout juniors learn how to help plant and help plants and flowers grow. Daisy money counts, financial literacy leaf. Girl Scout daisies learn about money and what it's worth. Girl Scout build girls of courage, confidence, and character and make the world a better place. Learn more, GirlScoutCookies.org. Girl Scout program, goal setting, decision making, money management, people skills, business ethics. Thin Mints help support. Your support helps girls do big things. Thank you. So there we go. Little Brownies. Little Brownie Bakers, LLC. And so, September 1st, 2017 is the expiration date. User freeze by. They're not going to last. Just putting that out there. They're not lasting that long. I have been trying to exercise more and eat less of this kind of stuff, so hopefully I will be able to find some sort of healthy alternative to Candy Tuesdays to counterbalance that, or I will just have to, you know, exercise more. Ooh, okay. Crumbly, definitely crumbly. So, right at the bat, pretty thin, actually. Pretty thin. Let's. It's so good. It's just so good. There's a glare. There we go. I could take down a sleeve of these no problem. This is more of a, like, you guys already knew what these tasted like. I'm just, you know, letting you all know that their Girl Scouts are out in full force, especially in my area. I was very happy to be able to support my coworker's daughter's troop. So support your local Girl Scouts. I'm sure they would appreciate it. It also helps them develop. Now, these are my personal favorite. Samoas. Chocolate, caramel, coconut. Crisp cookies coated in caramel sprinkled with toasted coconut and striped with dark chocolatey coating. Girl Scouts, speaking out on issues I care about allows me to inspire others to get involved and make a difference. Good. We need more passionate, strong-headed women in the working world. Girl Scout program, Samoas, join the adventure. That's the same badge, the gold award. Is this a cadet public speaking badge? Girl Scout cadets find their inner performer and lose the fear of speaking up. And then the literacy badge. Two cookies. Two. Just two. It's a lot of calories. But, I mean, you're eating a Girl Scout cookie. I mean, these things aren't supposed to be healthy. So, September. So, I mean, same freeze code there. These, I would say Samoas, these are my favorite. I guess a lot of people don't typically like the coconut. So move those out of the way. Move the box. I am definitely going to attempt to open this without killing the headphone users. Oh, shoot. Alright, well, I ripped the bag open, guys. I have to eat all of them. Look at that. That's a really good one. Got some nice striped veg on there. A little bit bigger, I would say. A little bit thicker than the Thin Mints. Probably just because there's a large coating on there. There's the inside. Yeah. I could eat these all day. There's a reason I'm big. It's cookies. But I am changing it, so hey. So good. Not as crumbly, but still, like, you know, you're gonna get flakes of coconut falling off everywhere. So, not bad. Man. Girl Scout cookies bring a lot of memories back growing up, because I had female cousins that would just fill our house with this stuff on a yearly basis. Boy. Really good. But takes forever to eat them. So, that leaves the Toffee-tastic gluten-free, rich, buttery cookies with sweet, crunchy toffee bits. Girl Scouts. My friends cheered me on, and I jumped higher than ever. Good. That girl seems more, like, shocked at what just happened. Like, oh. Or just overly dramatic. They're like, everyone act happy for your friend. And she's like, going for the Oscar, you know? Girl Scout program. Okay, so same gold there. We got the Brownie Fair Play badge. Girl Scout brownies learn how to play fair in sports. Alright. Ambassador on my own badge. Girl Scout ambassadors learn the importance of creating a budget, a skill that will help them wherever life leads. Stuff like this, like money management, public speaking, all that, I feel really should be taught in schools. Just as like a class on its own. You have math, science, you know, algebra, all this stuff, but like, I want some real world training. Like, come on. Like Girl Scouts, Boy Scouts, like all that. Like, it comes with the territory, I'm sure. As somebody who didn't go through Boy Scouts, you know, I'm sure, maybe, I don't know. Ooh, all right. So, one sleeve. These are giant cookies. Look at that. Gluten-free, toffee-tastic. Now, I'm sure these aren't going to be like the ones at, like, Starbucks or other places that sell, like, toffee cookies. Just because these are gluten-free, so they're going to have a different binder. What was the... rice flour, tapioca starch, sugar, butter, cream, salt, palm oil, brown rice flour, butter toffee bits, sugar butter, cream salt, corn syrup, soy salt, invert sugar, contains 2% less of salt, soy, xanthan gum, and baking powder, contains milk and soy product, Little Brownies, LLC. And so, Louisville, Kentucky. Sorry, just, no, all these were made in Louisville. Okay. I was just trying to see if I could find a different batch, but, you know. So, let's... Kind of tastes like a, like, not so dense shortbread cookie. It's a little grainy. I mean, that you're gonna get a lot of that from like grain-free kind of things with different flours and binders and things like that to keep everything together. They kind of have to add different things and it breaks down and bakes a little differently. I don't know. Not my favorite. I'll have to get used to it. Interesting. Okay. That is strange. I mean, this is the first time I've ever had a gluten-free cookie. It's a little odd. Tastes fine. Not a whole lot of flavor. But it's definitely not appalling. Like, I've had way worse. But... Well, all right, a little final bite, and I'm going to get this wrapped up, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, so that was a quick taste test slash reminder slash, you know, trip down memory lane. You know, everybody that I know of, and people who, you know, at least been in the U.S., I don't know if Girl Scout cookies are just a U.S. thing, or they're sold worldwide, but at least for myself and a lot of the people that I know, this is kind of a yearly thing. You know, you get some Girl Scout cookies, you know, you make the pilgrimage to your stores to go pick them up, or you have people in your family that enjoys them. You get some, you support the Girl Scouts, and life kind of moves on. You know, I will definitely say the Samoas are still some of my favorite, like my favorite cookie. I love Thin Mints. The gluten-free Toffee-tastic, given with milk, I think would be way better. It'd probably soften it quite a bit. I think that was my only issue with this, is it was very dry. With it being my first gluten-free cookie, yeah, it's still good. I mean, I think it needs a little bit more toffee bits. Maybe if I warmed them up, I don't know. If you're wondering about the hat, my hair is a mess today, and I picked this hat up at Hot Topic. I was on the clearance side, and I really like the show, so why not wear the hat? Son of Zorn, good show. If you are watching this, in the last week of February, the beginning of March, I will be doing given everything works out, I will be doing a 24-hour live stream with the Nintendo Switch. I am trying to capture an award that I've only made up, of being the very first 24-hour live Switch streamer. I keep wanting to say Twitch, which it will be on Twitch and YouTube, hopefully simultaneously. So check it out. We'll be right here on YouTube and on Twitch. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I don't do anything really much with Instagram. Twitter is always updated for me, thankfully, as I post videos. So yeah, check us out. We look forward to seeing you there. I'll be there all 24 hours. I may have some special guests coming by to try the Switch out, depending on what goes on. Hopefully the store, the GameStop that I'm going and picking it up to, has the charging grips in stock when I go, because the issue that I may have, and this is going off topic of Candy Tuesday, but just informing you, the issue that I may have is the Joy-Cons only get maybe 20 hours of charge. The only way to recharge them so far is to plug them into the Switch. I don't plan on getting the Pro Controller just yet. So what that turns into is if I unplug the Switch from the docking station, it will disconnect from the stream, so I can't do that. So we'll see. We'll see how it turns out. I will keep everybody up to date, but as of right now, 24-hour live stream going up. Boom, I'm excited. Thanks so much for coming by. This is another Candy Tuesday. Check us back for Unbox Friday / Review Friday, however I want to call it. But come back every Tuesday and Friday for more videos. My name is Cody. This was the Dream Saga, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.